While Rod's on stage entertaining his fans at stadiums all around the world, then there's one select group of people who ensure that it all runs smoothly. We're talking about the roadies.
And we're about to hear from one who toured the world for years with someone very close to Rod's heart. And thankfully, he took his camera along too.
My name is Peter Hince, and from 1973 until 1986, I had what was probably one of the best jobs in the world. I was a roadie for Queen. And everywhere I went, I took my camera. And many of these images haven't ever been seen. Just around this corner is where it all started for me. This was a rehearsal studio. Today, it's my local supermarket. This is where all the big bands of the day used to rehearse. And a very cold, miserable, damp November day is when I first met Queen. The general consensus was these guys are, yeah, a bunch of posers, really. And little did I know that I'd be spending the next 11 years of my life with them. This is a photo I took of a couple of the road crew outside the Hammersmith Odeon. Christmas Eve, 1975. Biggest show I think the band had played. Before the band went on stage, Fred, you could see he was mentally psyching himself up. But I mean, as soon as he went out and he hit the spotlight, and the crowd were with him, you know, and he knew that, and he could just take them and do what he wanted with them. Oh, he was a born performer, definitely. But it was an act. It wasn't really him. But off stage, he liked to play Scrabble. Queen were big, but after doing several shows here, it took them to a different level. Wow. Blimey. Haven't been here in well over 30 years. This was Psalm Studios. Here, Freddie worked on some of rock and roll's greatest albums. There were lots of Indian takeaways up the road, and Freddie was very keen on Indian food because he was of Indian descent, born in Zanzibar, educated in India, but he preferred to say he was Persian because it sounded a bit more interesting and exotic. And yeah, this photo here is Freddie in the basement, in the studio. I mean, who would know down there stuff like this had happened? You know, real rock and roll history. This is a photograph of the old Limehouse Studios, and it's where Queen filmed part of the I Want to Break Free video. I remember being on the shoot, and not a lot for me to do, so I could take candid photographs. They did a parody of Coronation Street and all dressed up in drag. I mean, the video was well received everywhere except in America. They didn't want rock stars to dress up as ladies. I want to break free. And MTV refused to play it. And the record company asked the band to do another video, a performance video. And basically, they just said no. And Fred probably said something stronger. And that was pretty much the beginning of the end for the band in America. And after all that, maybe the band could have split up. Along comes Bob Geldof and asks them to do something called Live Aid. Queen played the gig of their life. I mean, it was only 20 minutes, but what a 20 minutes. So you can see me on the side of the stage there in some fashionable cut-off denims of the time. And Live Aid was a momentous day for me and everybody. And the band, energized, went on and did their final tour the next year. But I kept in touch with the band and with Freddie particularly, and he was always invited me to his parties and also Christmas cards. And this, I think, has to be my favourite. Wishing you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year from the preening, pouting, posing, posturing old tart. Lots of love, Freddie. And I think that probably sums the old rascal up.
Love.
Wow, and you were loving those photos there.
What a man he was. I loved him to death. I tell you a story about when me and him and Elton were together.
Go on.
And we were going to form a band called Nose, Teeth and Hair. I was the hair.
Who was who, yeah?
Freddie was the teeth. No, I was the nose. Elton was the hair, Freddie was the teeth.
Yeah. And he was such an incredible performer and one of those people that came to life. As soon as he saw that crowd, that just injected something else into him, didn't it?
Sweetheart, absolutely sweetheart. I saw him just be, I don't know, about a month before he died, and a bit before he died, and we were at a party, and I was walking up behind him up a staircase. I didn't know he was ill. And he looked like he'd lost a lot of weight. And I said, Freddie, come on, man, when are you going to get the band together? You've been off the road too long. And he turned around and he went, Rod, I'm far too tired.
Oh.
And then I knew something was wrong. Mm. What a loss.
Yeah.
What a loss. Yeah. Bless him. Mm. All right, Freddie.
Hey.